Hello friend, welcome to you in official YouTube channel of Prashant Elmami. Today we are going to discuss some important formula of a spring, which are most important topic for diploma in third year mechanical engineering students. Now let us discuss the first formula. Whenever the curvature effect related to spring is to be neglected, then shear stress means tau is to be calculated by using formula tau is equal to Ks 8wd upon pi d cube. Where tau is the shear stress, Ks is wall's shear stress factor, then W is nothing but load applied on a spring, then capital D is nothing but mean diameter of spring, means suppose these are the spring, then this diameter is nothing but capital D, then small d is nothing but that particular wire diameter of the spring. Now Ks to be calculated by using formula 1 plus 1 upon twice C. C is nothing but spring index. Whenever the curvature effect in a spring is to be considered, then shear stress is calculated by using this formula tau is equal to K8WD upon pi d cube. Now the K is to be calculated by using this formula 4C minus 1 upon 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 upon C. Where P is nothing but spring index. This spring index is calculated by using this formula. C is the ratio of mean diameter of spring, means capital D, to the wire diameter of spring, means small d. Whenever the load is to be acted on a spring, then this spring is to be deflected at a certain distance. That deflection or delta is calculated by using this formula. Delta is equal to 8wd cube n upon gd raised to 4. Where n is the number of coil in a spring, that is nothing but this one coil, this another coil, and so on. Okay, then g is nothing but modulus of rigidity of spring material. Now the spring stiffness is calculated by using this formula. S is equal to load per unit deflections. Load is nothing but w and deflection is nothing but delta, which is calculated by using this formula. Now the strain energy stored in a spring is calculated by U is equal to 1/2 load into deflection, where U is nothing but strain energy stored in a spring, W is nothing but load acted on a spring, delta is nothing but deflection of spring. Okay, then next formula is LS. LS means solid length of spring, which is to be calculated by N dash into D. Okay, where n dash is nothing but total number of turn in a helical compression spring, and d is nothing but wire diameter of spring. Now free length of spring is to be calculated by using this formula. Lf is equal to n dash d plus delta max plus 1.5 into delta max, where delta max is nothing but maximum deflection of a spring. Small d is nothing but wire diameter of spring. N dash is nothing but total number of turn in a helical compression spring. Now the next formula is kinetic energy. Okay, kinetic energy is nothing but 1/2 mv square, where m is a mass and v is a velocity. Then after that, torque is to be calculated by using basic formula. Torque is nothing but T is equal to force into perpendicular distance. In case of spring, force is to be considered W. W into perpendicular distance means mean diameter divided by 2, capital D divided by 2. Okay. Then after that, torque is to be calculated in terms of shear stress by using torsional equation already discussed in previous lecture. T is equal to pi by 16 tau d cube, where T is a torque, tau is a shear stress, and D is the wire diameter of spring. Then after that, last important formula of spring is pitch. Pitch is nothing but adjacent distance between two spring. Okay, that distance is calculated by using this formula Lf upon n dash minus 1, where Lf is the free length, which is calculated by using this formula, and n dash minus 1. Okay, hope you understand some. This is an important formula of a spring while using for solving the problem. Thank you very much.